Good day everyone, I hope you're well. Are you tired of feeling like you can't keep up with the increasing costs of everyday expenses? Well, you're not alone. In this video, we're going to break down the reasons behind the rising cost of living and share practical tips to help you navigate this economic challenge. So sit tight, take notes, and let's get started. It's no secret the rising cost of living has been a growing concern for billions of people around the world. And you can see this from the heat map on your screen as well. But in this video, we will focus on the 2022 numbers in Australia, New Zealand, India, Canada, the USA, and the UK, and what they signal for the year 2023. These are not just numbers. They have serious impact on our daily life. But it's very important that we clearly understand the difference between the inflation and the cost of living, because these terms will be used throughout this video. So inflation and cost of living is not same, but they are two sides of the same coin. Cost of living refers to the cost associated with maintaining a certain lifestyle, which varies with places, person, and even cities. For example, the cost of living in Sydney will be different than the cost of living in Adelaide. Whereas inflation refers to the increase in the price level of services and goods over time in an economy. In other words, inflation is the rate at which the value of a currency is falling, and consequently, the general level of prices for goods and services is rising. Now let's take a closer look at some of the key factors that are driving this trend in each of these countries, as well as some of the key actions that governments and central banks in these countries have taken to curb the rising cost of living. Let's start with Australia, because I live here and like yourself, I'm also going through the cost of living burden. In Australia, the high cost of living is largely attributed to the cost of housing, gas, electricity, and fuel bills, along with rising food and fuel prices. If you have started to imagine how it feels like filling up the grocery trolley in Australia nowadays, then you are not alone. Additionally, the Australian economy is heavily influenced by global economic factors such as the cost of raw materials and change in foreign exchange rates. In fact, according to movinggist.com, Australia is around 24% costlier than the US. To combat inflation, the Reserve Bank of Australia has implemented a monetary policy framework aimed at maintaining low and stable inflation. While the key purpose of the rate hike is to curb the spending to control the inflation, in reality, it's not as good as it sounds. On Tuesday, 7th March 2023, Australians witnessed 10th cash rate rise and the fastest since 1990. The rapid rise in the cash rate has intensified the financial burden that we face in Australia. To put things in perspective, I have prepared an example that you can see on your screen. The government is also taking initiative to offer cost of living relief, such as cutting the cost of medicines, investing in infrastructure projects to create jobs and stimulate economic growth. Besides, there is a one-off $250 payment, as you can see on your screen. I don't want to say anything, but I'll leave this for the viewers to decide how much this payment will help in easing the cost of living pressure in a country where the current cost of living for a single person is around $3,766 per month, compared to $7,065 per month for a family of four, covering just bare essentials. Now, moving on to India. In India, one of the main reasons for the high cost of living is the rapidly growing population and increasing urbanization, which has led to higher demand for goods and services. Additionally, high oil prices, supply chain disruptions due to pandemic, and food inflation have contributed to the rising cost of living. To help curb inflation, the Reserve Bank of India has raised interest rates and implemented tighter monetary policies to reduce the supply of money circulation. The Indian government is also implementing measures to increase the production of essential goods, reduce import dependencies, and promote sustainable agriculture. Surprisingly, inflation in India is in much better condition compared to some of the top global economies. So just stick around and see how they compare. The next one in my list is a beautiful country called New Zealand. In New Zealand, the cost of living is driven by a combination of factors, including the high cost of housing, fuel prices, mainly the gas, electricity, and petrol prices, and inflation in cost of goods and services. Housing costs in particular have risen significantly, with some families spending up to 60% of their income on rent or mortgage payments. But what else fueled the cost of living in New Zealand? Well, country's reliance on imports and high export prices for agriculture products also contributed to the high cost of living. To control inflation, the Reserve Bank of New Zealand has adopted a flexible inflation targeting regime, while the government is implementing measures to increase the supply of affordable housing and improve public transport infrastructure. The New Zealand government is also offering subsidies for public transport fares and petrol excise duty cut to offer cost of living relief. Moving on to Canada. In Canada, the high cost of living is attributed by factors such as the cost of housing, healthcare, and education, along with the rising energy and food prices. Housing costs in particular have risen significantly, with some families spending up to 50% of their income on rent or mortgage payment. Key drivers for Canada's rising cost of living include, and global economic factors also contributed to the cost of living. To manage inflation, the Bank of Canada has set an inflation target of 2%, while the Government of Canada introduces legislation to make life more affordable for Canadians and announced a one-time tax-free top-up payment of $500 to provide direct support to low-income renters. Canadian government is also implementing measures to reduce carbon emission, invest in affordable housing, and increase access to healthcare. Now moving on to the world's biggest economy, and that is the USA. In the USA, the high cost of living is driven by factors such as cost of housing, healthcare, and education, along with rising energy and food prices. Healthcare costs, in particular, have risen significantly, with many families struggling to pay for necessary medical treatments. This has led to long wait times and a strain on the healthcare system. People are feeling stressed and tired from the constant financial pressure. Much like Canada, the country's reliance on import and global economic factors also contributed to the cost of living. To address inflation, the Federal Reserve has set an inflation target of 2% and has implemented a range of monetary policies to manage the money in supply. But the rising inflation in USA and across the world could be somehow linked with USA's money printing. According to NASDAQ, by mid-2021, USA's all-in-money printing totaled about $13 trillion, including $5.2 trillion for pandemic support, $4.5 for quantitative easing, and $3 trillion for infrastructure. It's no secret that mountains of money cause inflation. You can click the small I card on top to watch my video on Sri Lanka to understand how money printing led to economic and financial turmoil. I have also shared the link in description, so don't worry. You can watch it later if you want. Similar to Canada, the US government activated cost of living adjustment, or COLA, which seems to have long-term vision, but it's hard to say anything if the COLA will offer any immediate relief. In the UK, the cost of living increased sharply across the UK during 2021 and 2022. The annual rate of inflation reached 11.1% in October 2022, a 41-year high, before easing in subsequent months to 10.1% in January 2023. High inflation affects the affordability of goods and services for households. The high cost of living is driven by factors such as the cost of housing, transportation, and food, along with the rising energy prices, especially the gas price and the electricity price. Just for the context, from January 2022 to January 2023, domestic gas prices increased by 129% and domestic electricity prices by 67%. Additionally, Brexit and the pandemic have also had an impact on inflation. Like other developed economies, to control inflation, the Bank of England has set an inflation target of 2%, and the government is implementing measures to support small businesses, invest in infrastructure projects, and reduce carbon emission. So, what can we do to combat the rising cost of living? Thankfully, there are ways you can generate some passive income by launching online courses, using platforms like Udemy, sell ebooks, do affiliate marketing, invest in REITs, and so on. It may sound a big task, but you have technology by your side here. You can use AI tool such as ChatGPT to get answer to your side hustle questions, and also watch my video on how to make passive income using ChatGPT by clicking the small icon on top or by clicking the link from description. It's clear that the rising cost of living is a complex issue, influenced by a range of factors specific to each country. However, governments and central banks around the world are taking steps to manage inflation and help ease the burden on households. It remains to be seen how effective these measures will be in the long term. We hope this video has been informative and helpful. Please don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to our channel for more content like this one. Please remember, you're helping others by sharing this video as they may be looking for similar information. Thank you.